Hello friends, welcome to Talent Crafts.
Hello friends, welcome to my fourth video tutorial of Python. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build in modules and function. If you remember, in the last video, I showed you how you can use numbers and how you can add numbers or else how you can find exponent of any number. So let's take an example. If we want to find exponent of any number, so let me take 3 raised to 4. So I want to find 3 to the power of 4, and how we can do is I'll just enter, and that's correct, right friends? But now there is another way we can do the same thing. And we can do this by using the built-in function which are inbuilt in Python. So friends, what is function? Function is a part of code which executes some given logic to it. So now let's find out exponent of 3 to the power of 4 by function, that is by built-in function which is given. So what you can take POW, that is the power, and in the parentheses you can write 3, 4. So I want 3 to the power of 4, so I'll write 3, 4. Now just enter and you can find the same answer, right friends? Let us now see how you can view all built-in functions. So there are a lot of functions, so how you know that which functions are available in Python? So let's check it. What you can do is there is a command for viewing all these functions in Python. So all you have to do is write dir and in the parentheses and double underscore built-in, again double underscore, and just enter. So friends, you can see all the built-in functions here. For example, what we take POW, right? So where it is, here you can see it. And there are other functions as well, like mean, max, help, hex. So you can even find hex of any number. So now what it will do is it will return all functions which are already built in Python. So if you type dir in the parentheses under double underscore built-ins, then again on double underscore, it will return you all the functions which are already built in Python. So now you use any of this function. For example, I'll take simply max function, and then in the parentheses I'll write some numbers. For example, I'll type 2, then 3, 4, 10, 11, 15, 9, 1. So this are all my numbers. These are all my numbers. And what it will do it, it will return me the maximum number from it. Means the greatest number out of it. So let's check it. Oh yeah, it returns me 15 out of this, because 15 is the greatest number. So it gives the maximum value out of the number. Let's take another example. For example, I'll take, so let's take an example of len. So what is len? It will give the length of any string. It will return me the length of any string. For example, let's take L-E-N and then in the parentheses I can't type any string, so I'll typing simply hello everyone. So this is hello everyone. And how many letters does, how many words does it contains? It's 1, 2, it's almost 14. So what it will give me, it will give me the length of the string. So let's check it out. So it is giving me 14 as an answer. So these are all the functions which are built in Python. And now you know that these are all the functions. So you basically know that this is all the functions now. But how to know what is its functionality? What's its functionality, what it works for? So to check this, what we can do is we can use a built-in function help. So where is my help? This is my help built-in function. I can use simply help function to check functionality of all other built-in functions. For example, I want to check functionality of ABS. What is ABS? I don't know what is ABS. So I want to check that what exactly it does, what exactly and how the function works. So I'll type help and in the parentheses I'll type the function. So it's ABS and then enter. So what help is doing here is it is telling us what ABS actually does. So what it is written over here, that return the absolute value of the argument. So what ABS function does is it returns the value of argument. So now we know what does this function ABS does. It gives us an absolute value, correct friends? So let's check it out. So I'll type ABS and in the parentheses I'll check absolute value of 5. So you all know friends, like absolute value is getting the distance from 0 till the number. So what it will return me back is it will return me back obviously 5. So let's see. Okay, so it is correct. It returns me 5 back. That is the absolute number of 5. Now let's take another example of absolute value of minus 5. Now what it will give me, it only gives the positive integer number. So it will return me again 5. So friends, this was all about built-in functions. Now let's see how built-in module works. So built-in modules are something which contains extra functions. So it contains extra functions. It is a type of function. So let's find out what is built-in modules. So for that, let me take an example. Like let's find out factorial of any number. So what is factorial, friends? Factorial is the product of all positive integers less than or equal to the number. So it is the product, that is multiplication of all the numbers that is less or equal to number. So what I need to do first is I have to write import, and as I have to find the factorial of a number, so what I need is math. So what I will do is I will import math, and then so import math and then math dot press the shift key. So you will see all the built-in modules here. So it's a cos, a sine, a tan. Then you can see all the built-in modules here. Now I need factorial, right? I need to find factorial of number. So this is factorial. So I'll simply enter. Now press enter. So it is added in built-in function factorial. Now enter once again. And now I can find number factorial of any number. So math dot factorial and the parentheses, the number of which I want to find factorial. So I'll write 3. And what is the factorial for 3, friends? 3 cross 2 cross 1. So that's 6. And that's correct, right? So this is how you can find built-in modules, and it is very lengthy, like math dot factorial, and then you have to type the number in parentheses. So what you can do is you can also store this built-in module, that is math dot factorial, into a variable. So in the last video, as I showed you how you can how you can use variables. So now it's time to use a variable. So I'll give it a name, simply fact is equal to math dot factorial. So this is added into a variable name fact. Now what I can do is I can simply type fact and in the parentheses I'll type the number of which I want to find factorial of. So I'll take an example of 4. So here we go, and this is the correct answer, friends. So this is how you can even store built-in modules in a variable. So friends, today we learned how to use built-in modules and function in Python. Hope you guys like my video, and if you do so, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Talent Crafts. Also click on bell icon for getting notified. I will be bringing the videos soon again. Till then, stay tuned to Talent Crafts. Bye.